About to leave, thinking that all was dead, he heard the sound of a rubbity-dub right above his head.
Oh, he heard the sound of a rubbity-dub right above his head.
Now the baker's boy was cunning and wise, and he crept up those stairs, and he crept up so silently he caught them unawares. And there he saw the butcher's boy between his mistress's thighs, and they were having a rubbity-dub right before his eyes.
Oh, they were having a rubbity-dub right before his eyes.
Now the chandler's wife was much alarmed, and leaping from the bed, she turned unto the baker's boy, and this is what she said. If you would but my secret keep, just bear this fact in mind. You can always come down for a rubbity-dub whenever you feel inclined.
Oh, you can always come down for a rubbity-dub whenever you feel inclined.
Now the baker's boy was filled with joy at the prospect of such fun. He vowed he'd leap upon the bed when the butcher's boy had done. But when it came to the shorter strokes, how he kissed that chandler's wife, he vowed he'd have a rubbity-dub every day of his life.
Oh, he vowed he'd have a rubbity-dub every day of his life.
Now in the morn when he awoke, all over he did quake. His back was sore, his balls were raw, all over he did shake. And when he looked at his John Tom, he saw he'd done the trick. The consequence of his rubbity-dub was pimples on his...
Oh, the consequence of his rubbity-dub was pimples on his...
Now the baker's boy to the doctor went some ointment for to buy. The doctor looked him up and down and heaved a mighty sigh. My boy, the doctor said, you've been a bloody fool. You'll never more have a rubbity-dub, I'm gonna cut off your tooth.
Oh, you'll never more have a rubbity-dub, I'm gonna cut off your tooth.
Now listen to the baker's boy, for he should surely know, an enthusiastic amateur is worse than any pro. And if you would a wooing go and self-control you lack, whenever you have a rubbity-dub, be sure to wear a Mac.
Oh, whenever you have a rubbity-dub, be sure to wear a Mac.